the country could lose billions of shillings should it go ahead to discontinue the Kimwarer Dam project and downscale the Arror Dam project as directed by President Uhuru Kenyatta. This is subject to contractual agreements that, according to Water Cabinet Secretary Simon Chelugui in an earlier statement, would have serious ramifications, not just financial, but also on relations between Kenya and Italy. Sam Gituku has that report.
The Arror and Kimwarer dams are the subject of a court case facing more than 20 officials, including National Treasury Cabinet Secretary Henry Rotich. The officials face several corruption-related charges, among them inflating the cost of the two dams that are to be constructed in Elgeyo Marakwet County. Just yesterday, the president cancelled the Kimwarer dam project for being economically unviable, that its cost had been exaggerated at 22.2 billion shillings. The Arror dam had been costed at 28.5 billion shillings, and after a technical committee appointed by the president returned recommendations for review, it will now be downscaled to a 60-meter dam and not 96 meters, that reducing the cost to at most 15.4 billion shillings. While the court case continues, partly for inflating the loan sought vis-a-vis the estimated cost, and with the contractor Italian firm CMC di Ravenna also facing charges, the presidential directive could complicate matters further. According to Water Cabinet Secretary Simon Chelugui, who appeared at the National Assembly Environment Committee in July, options are limited in delinking with CMC di Ravenna that is also implementing the multi-billion shilling Itare dam in Nakuru. At that time, Chelugui feared that cancelling the contract with the firm was untenable as it would expose the country to losing monies already paid for the project. On top of that, the government would lose 10% of the contractual amount for pulling out, but also risk hurting relations between Nairobi and Rome as the contract had government interventions.
The issue of termination is likely to cost us to lose the payments we have done, and it can also lead to cross default, meaning any other funding that we receive from Italy or any other is going to impact on this on our other programs.
At that time, Chelugui said the best option was to retain CMC di Ravenna as the main contractor, but recruit subcontractors to do the work, or the finances would be secured in an escrow account. If Chelugui's insights on the cancellation of the dam project is anything to go by, then the country could lose all the funds already paid for Kimwarer Dam, plus 10% of the 22.2 billion shillings cost. But there is a corruption case in court, with no permanent works on the ground, despite the payments. With the Arror Dam scope and cost revised to between 13 and 15 billion shillings, questions abound on whether the bankrupt CMC di Ravenna can be expected to implement it, and at what cost, given the lost value of contract. Should the government choose to award the contract to another firm, the fears CS Chelugui expressed would be a question to consider. But in HZ area of Keio South, residents' views are divided, with little concern over the country's loss.
Hii dam, kama raisi angesema dam ya Kimwarer na Arror tupiliwe mbali, ingetupiliwe mbali sote mbili, kwa sababu pesa saisi dam sote silifujwa. Watu walikula hii pesa. Sisi tulikuwa tunatarajia ripoti ya DCI ya kwamba fulani alichukua pesa ngapi, fulani alichukua ngapi. Na kwa sababu president amesimamisha kwa kafla, sisi kama waathiriwa tunataka tulipwe pesa yenye tulitumiwa kwa public participation.
Kwa hivyo mimi naunga president hii term ipotelewe mbali kabisa, ndio sisi tuishi mashamba ya babu zetu kwa salama salamini.
Calls to the members of the technical team that recommended changes to the two dam projects advise that it is the president to make public details on the way forward, with CS Chelugui distancing himself from the two dams that are under the East African Affairs and Regional Development docket. Sam Kitukusweze, NTV.